Morning, everyone. It's such a pleasure to be here with you. Always, always, always. I always hear all the good things that's going on with you guys. You guys are just really doing a fine job. A lot of you that have been in pain and suffering all these years have pulled, finally found your remedy and a way out. I just love all that. And so keep it up. Keep up the good work. Those that are suffering, keep hanging in there. Don't give up. I'm going to tell you, the biggest thing people do is they give up too quick. Yeah, it's a lot of work, no question about it. But when you stop and think about it, it took years and generations through this protein eating. Someone asked me about protein again. So I am going to go over it with you again. Ask me why about meat again, and I've covered that in several videos. But look at the advent of man away from the tropics, and that's when you saw the decline of the health. And so I want to talk to you about meat. They ask you, what about meat's not good for you? I've got another question. What about meat is good for you? What about decayed flesh, putrefaction, is good for you? Now, I realize the glandulars and the stem cell effects of that sort of speak, but as a rule, what is good and healthy about a dead animal? If you ate it raw, I might, you know, might argue with you that, okay, but this idea of protein and animal flesh and all this somehow being good for a person, just not there. And we'll talk about that later, and you know how rotten, how putrefaction affects the Homo sapien. And again, I likened it to the cows that they just in Europe, where they decided to give them other cows, making them basically cannibals. And of course, that's where the hoof and mouth and the mad cow came from. A toxicity. You know, just heavy acidosis and toxicity. So, I do want to go down the line here, and I want to continue. I actually want to kind of finish today with the iris reading. I designed this to educate you on how to read your own eyes. So, I've asked many of you to send your eyes in, and boy, you've done a great job. Some of them not so good that we can read, but I'll tell you what, you've done a great job for yourselves. And I'm going to go over a whole bunch of eyes now. Now, one of them's hooked to a five-page thing, and I just can't. If you send me five pages of stuff, it's going to be real hard for me to read it right now. It's just that I'm so busy that to take time and read five pages, is that's how busy I am. But I'll do my very best to help every one of you as we go along here. So let's start with these eyes. And these eyes belong to... Well, actually, I have two sets here, don't I? Yeah, I have Gina and Brian. So I think the first one, who's the first one? Brian. Okay, we're going to move that. Chris is in here helping me, so we're going to go back to looking at the eyes again. And I'll use my pointer, and we'll go into that, and I'll go through that. Now, I want you to keep in mind that always, when you're thinking about botanicals, and you're thinking about how do you use them in conjunction with the diet to get well, know why we're using them. We're using them to help you accelerate cleaning of the lymph system. Those are the more astringent herbs, the lymphatic herbs. We are helping to rebuild kidneys out there, rebuild endocrine glands out there, clean up the bowels, and rebuild cells. So look at why we use herbs. We use herbs for cleaning and strengthening. And that's how you kind of want to look at it, because looking at herbs to treat diseases is ridiculous. And obviously that whole concept of treatment of diseases is illusionary and has cost a lot of human lives, a lot of human suffering, and part of the mix of why humans are at this level of decay of their health. It's how we decided to treat ourselves instead of understanding simple relationships of food, air, water, thought and feelings in relationship to one's beingness. So we're learning, interestingly. So just keep in mind that we always recommend the stomach and bowel formulas, the lymphatic formulas, the kidney formulas, the endocrine gland formulas, the glandulars related to the endocrine glands. Those are the focus with the herbs. Because if I sit and take every case and tell you what you need to take, then it's just chewing up too much time, and I'm leaving a lot of poor people without being able to talk to them. So the herbal protocols are going to be the same unless you want to use circulation or you want to get up and get new hair growth. We're going to show you a lovely lady that did a marvelous job. You've already seen her. If you hooked to Facebook, you already see all her hair. But This is, you guys laughed at me when you first came on here about hair. I think some of you are not laughing anymore. Got a lot of full head of hair now. I don't lie, I'll tell you that. We see this all the time. I watch you. So I know when you're improving or not improving. We can see it. Your whole body tells the story, from the hair to the skin, everything. So anyway, let's go on down this line and have some fun here. This is Brian and Gina. Give me a second to get around and we'll be all set. Yeah, this is, can you get that? You want me to scoot that, Chris? Are you good there?
Perfect.
Oh, wow. Okay. All right. This is Brian, and this is his right eye. Happy if I turn this the right way, wouldn't it? All right. So you see all this white. Now consider an eye like a wagon wheel. Remember, here's the hub of the wheel. And here's hundreds of little fibers that emanate out, under which is the rods and cones. Now, anytime the fibers have a deviation like this, like these patterns, we call those lacunas. The deeper ones, crypts. I like to just simply use the concept of fiber patterns. When you take a look at this eye, you will notice there is very little fiber patterns. You hardly see a few little places. That's a kidney right there, little bitty. This is called a strong constitution. When those fibers are nice and straight, that's George Burns. These people have the genes up in the 90s and 100s or more, and yet these guys abuse themselves probably the most. And old biker friends like this that live, up in their 70s and 80s, and what they've done to their bodies couldn't even be described. So you can see here with the two that his eye should be blue, which it is. But you can see the different colorations different in the cameras and things. But it's enough to say that obviously a blue eye. You do see these patterns here, which is still a fairly good constitution. I'd say high end, medium, or low high. But when you see this white stuff, yellow stuff, brown stuff on top of fibers, whatever's on top of the fibers, like all this white stuff, she has some. That's lymph. And if you'll notice, we talked about this is the collaret, like the collar of a shirt. This is the collaret around the pupil. Now, Brian, you've got a perfect stomach ring here. You should never see this stomach ring, but you see this perfect circle around the pupil. Now, if you look at your iris charts, this is the stomach, and that's over acidic. You see that little brown ring around the pupil there? That is a malabsorption ring. Well, if we have a malabsorption ring, we're going to walk right out to the bowel wall. And this, the collaret wall, which we're looking at here, the collaret wall. See that little white rope look? That little thickened white area that follows the bowel line? And matter of fact, when you follow the bowel line, you're actually following the way your bowels are designed inside. Whether they're weak, prolapsed, ballooned, like this is a little prolapsed ascending colon here, a little prolapsed hepatic flexor, which is the flexor that curves under the right breast chest area and goes across. So all this white is lymphatic, but in the anals of lymphatics, not bad. A lot of congestion in the forehead here and up in the tonsil area. This is a lot of congestion in the upper back head area. Here's a weakness in the neck and the throat area, so gives you a sore throat generally when you're detoxing. This is the leg here, so from the knee down, you have a weakness in the leg and also up in the femur, so that's a little bit of a weak leg. Right here's the adrenal glands. There's the kidney. Not too bad. A lot of congestion there. When you start seeing these little whiter dots, and let me see if I can see one for you here. Now let me show you while I'm thinking about this. Let me show you these white dots first. You see how these little white dots are? And if you look on an iris chart, this is all in the lymph node area. not the lymphatic area. This is lymph node. Lymphatic's all through the body, but these are lymph nodes. And you see these little white dots? That's a lymphatic rosary around the eye. And that means that those lymph nodes are swollen. A lot of people have had their lymph nodes swollen most of their lives because their kidneys aren't filtering. And this is the left eye, and you can see there's the real bad kidney, and it's just not filtering these lymph nodes. Major interstitial lymphatic constipation here. I want to show you why, Brian, I'm saying that about you. Here's a dairy farmer. Here's a dairy farmer up here from Upper New York. See how thick that lymph system is in this guy? He also has an ice cream manufacturing business. So he came in one day, he's 84 when I took this picture, and he was mad at me because I had the book in my office on milk and how bad it was for you. And he said, I'm 84 because I drink milk. You're very wrong. I said, no, you're 84 because you have good genes. You're in here with cancer because of the milk. Now, let's look at this. This is up here getting into the right ear, the right cerebellum. And remember, we talked about this is the dizzy equilibrium center up here. So, Brian, you've got this coming your way here, right side cerebellum, back of the neck. A lot of congestion up here in the sinuses. This looks like the pituitary area or close to it. This would be the pineal. So your rest would be somewhat disturbed maybe at times. This is going into the bladder and lower back here. Then your kidneys, a little groin, not bad. I mean, these are fairly good genes. This is probably pancreatic and right testicle. And you see how that white, see how this white ring is around these areas? That's why Jensen said that these areas of weakness always has a compromised lymph and blood flow. Well, I'll say this, it definitely has a compromised lymph flow, and these are always the areas that's problematic. When we shift around here on the right side there, pancreas, testicle, liver, gallbladder, all that needs to be strengthened up. All that's weak through this area here. Here we get into the bronchial trunks, of course, here. Not bad, though. I'm saying that. Here is Brian's left eye. Now, you see this blood vessel in your right eye? That's fixated, pointing right at that weakness right there in the throat. This is probably C-spine weakness, so you better check your C-spine to see if it's not pinching, because that shows that there's stress or pinching in that area here, and it's related right to that area of weakness in the throat or upper neck area. You also have it here related to the liver. See the sclera? And your sclera is a lot of red in there, and all this is shows acidosis. It all should be white. You shouldn't see these big blood vessels. That's sclerology. Left side, you still see all these blood vessels here. Very acidic person. The stomach shows very acidic. The eye is a very acid-looking eye. On the left side, it looks to me like you have more lymphatic issues than the right. Again, here's the upper femur. A lot of lymph in the adrenal gland. So much so that you have to be careful not to get cysts or tumors growing on your adrenal gland there. This is the prostate. See, that's sticking out, so you have to be careful with your prostate. And then we enter into the lower back. You're getting up toward the mid-back and up to the throat area again. So you've got to just clean and strengthen. Good body here, just got to clean and strengthen. Again, a lot of sinus congestion left side. We're back into the lower brain, cerebellum, and left ear over here. You see a big prolapsing of the transverse colon. So I'm going, well, that seems to be a lot of parathyroid going on. We're seeing a lot of connective tissue weaknesses, a lot of skeletal weaknesses. So we're going to go to the parathyroid. And right there, now it looks like the bowel's just ballooned there. And that's a small bowel, but it's ballooned quite large. So I think the parathyroid is encompassed in that bowel wall there. And I think you have to really work on your parathyroid gland. I definitely would go to the glandulars on that, because we don't know what herbs are for the parathyroid. And that'll strengthen the body up and the skeletal system up pretty good there. Okay, now here's the wife, Gina. Now, Gina, you have got a lot of lymphatic things going on, sweetheart. This is the blue eye. So think of your eye like this. All right? You want to see what a brown eye looks like? Here's a true brown eye. See the difference in your color? Sorry, Chris. See your difference in the colors here, how brown? This isn't a brown, this is green. But in there, you've got a haze of orange. It's a sulfur in there. Now see how you're ballooned out here in your bowels here, but how you go down here, this is the right eye. So your hepatic flexure is also dropped down or ballooned down, common stuff. But you want to work on your bowels all along your bowel here. You also have a stomach ring. It's very faint. But your bowels here need to be worked on. You have a lot of weaknesses along your gut. This is all the ascending colon. And then when I look at your left eye, this is all wrapping around to your descending colon, your sigmoid flexure, and then out your rectum. And you just need to work on your GI tract. This is subacute. Subacute turns a blue eye yellow. This is all subacute stage of lymphatic issues mixed with sulfur. And it's just turned your eye green looking. Don't know about cataracts, Brian. I think I saw a little in yours, but let's go back to this right eye here. This is the knee on the right side, a little groin on the right side. Basically got a lot of lymph going on in the pancreas in the right ovary. Might be a little gallbladder here issue going on. Want to strengthen that up, but really move your lymph. Look how thick your lymph system is here. And this is your upper back, throat, thyroid, and tonsil area. And this could be a drug. This could be a chemical. See how it's like a cloud over the landscape there? Well, that's a cloud on top of a cloud. Again, you see you got the same thing going here. This goes to your tonsil area here, though. Looks like. Throat. But you got a strong constitution. You just got a lot of lymph here showing up. Looks like a nerve ring in there a little bit. Right there's a nerve ring going around. So that's the adrenals, but this is in the central nervous system. But your pupil's a nice size, so, you know, just clean and strengthen. You really want to look at your parathyroid, too, because you got a lot of prolapsing here going on, some ballooning going on. Right here is your parathyroid area, and that's a huge I'm on the right side. However, this is a big bronchial trunk weakness. Over here is the parathyroid right there. See, and you got a big weakness right there. So get on your parathyroid here. Now, left eye. Same type of thing. A lot of lymph here. Wow. I wonder what if this is the proper colorations here, because here's the throat area right here, and upper neck right here, lower back right here. This is bladder, uterine and vaginal. Might want to do some douching and strengthening up. They use the female reproductive formula. Here's the knee and the upper femur. So work on that parathyroid with, you know, parathyroid formula. Kidney, not too bad. That's nestled right in there. You do see a little bit of weakness here. Not too bad. Adrenals are not too bad. You just need to clean and strengthen your body up. I don't see anything that, you know, except for the upper necks here and throats and a few things like that. You just have to really get in that parathyroid to strengthen yourself up. But you really have to spend some time moving your lymph system. Pretty. Now, this is lung. The mid lobe of the right lung, left lung. So there's not mid lobe. There's no mid lobe in the left lung, is there? So this is lower lobe. This is some kind of drug or something up in the ear area. That looks like the left ear weakness right there. Could be at the left shoulder. I can't take the time to chart these out because I just don't have the time. But anyway, that should help you guys there. Take off on that. I'll go over your case, see if there's anything else to see. Stay, I'll check my email, one of your videos. Oh, you're a sweetheart. Thank you, Gina and Brian. I hope that helps you. Both of you got pretty good eyes there, but get on your parathyroids, clean those lymphs, and I think you all will come out pretty good on that side of that. If you need to grab anything else, just grab it with that. Now, this is cute. This is really cute. Look at that cute picture. Isn't that a little cutie pie? And she's given some clue here, over here, taking an eye like that. Beautiful structure here. But thick, and we've showed you these eyes before. Thick lymph. I just don't have a better picture to show you how much. When pictures aren't taken perfectly, and no, you know, it's hard to get it done. So no negativity here from me, but it's hard to get good pictures, and just the colors have got to be set right to make sure you're getting an accurate look. But it's obvious. See how thick all this orange stuff is. Even from here, your eye looks very brown. See, now this looks orange, but if she got the right coloration, this could just be brown. Well, for me, this is hard to see whether she actually has blue eyes or not. If this is her when she's a baby, if this is her when she's a baby, see those beautiful blue eyes? Look at this. Major change lymphatically. So I don't know how these are two the same people. If they are, then there's no question you have blue eyes. Your lymph system has got chronically backed up on you. See that malabsorption ring, that brown ring around the pupil? You've got a nice shaped bowel, though. I mean, considering today's world, hard to see right now. This looks like the left eye here, so that would be the kidney right there and adrenal. You got good genes here. You got some nerve rings, so your adrenals are down there and your nervous system down. That's all genetic passing. But you got a good bowel form to deal with. You got a little, looks like pineal, might be picking up pituitary, but pineal, let's see if we have a right eye here. You can see your stomach ring right here. But all in all, you got a nice bowel thing. This is in the lower back here, which would go to the kidneys. Hard to see under there to see if there's any real fiber changes because this is so thick that a lot of times we can't see underneath. Now, this is a skin ring. So your skin, what's happening is you lost your filtration of your kidneys and your skin. So what you've got is heavy accumulation in the body. Someone did give you sulfa drugs, which really started your downhill slide of accumulation there. So I'd have to read your email to see, and right now I haven't read it. I apologize, but I'm trying to go over these eyes and get a little catch-up done here. Possible to send you a donation through PayPal. Send donations to PayPal. I don't know. We got to find someone to handle donations. We've only had a couple of them, and every one of them, I want you guys to know, we give herbs out for that amount to whoever's suffering the most and has no money. We always do. We do it ourselves. I'll have to read through this and maybe get back with you, sweetheart. She's a female, 43 years old, no significant illness, but I'm very toxic looking. Oh, you're very. Mercury poisoning recently, but feeling almost back to normal. Good. Kidneys filter pretty well. Perfect. See, she's got a good body there. She just hasn't got the filtration. You see, blood pressure is low, 90 to 95 over 60. Well, the 60 is your kidney, so that's good. You got good genes. You just got a lymph system backed up there. The 90 to 95, of course, systolic means low blood pressure, means adrenals. Green eye, see, green eye. See, so you don't have green eyes, sweetheart. You actually have blue eyes that have turned on you, sweetheart. So let's see, pulse has always been a bit high, probably to bring oxygen to the body more because you're so lymphatically backed up. See, I'm 5'5", 110 pounds since I was 16 years old. Okay, so I should show you YouTubers the blue eyes. God, yeah, you know what? Here's what she's saying. She says, I enclosed my eyes at 8 months old so you can show the YouTubers how bright blue, that's her, can quickly become a toxic brown. I also submitted my eyes from 2006 to show the difference after almost a decade of 90% raw vegan. When I was young, we had a Spanish maid, and my mom said that maid turned my eyes brown. I wonder what she gave her. That's freaky. Oh my God, that's freaky. Well, you know what? Spanish tend to have a lot of pastas and white flowers and stuff like that, and maybe that was it. But whatever it was, that reminds me of something a dairy product would do because it's super clogged. And look at that, beautiful blue to almost brown. Well, sweetheart, you can get that blue back. As you got it, you can reverse it, dear one, and do not stop. Keep going and clean up your lymph system. You got good genes, is why you don't feel anything, but your lymph system is chronically backed up. And you just, excuse me, unback it. This is going to be a little bit of test for you, man. I'm so used to Drew sitting there. We got Drew here. We got Chris. Can you get on that? Can you see that?
Yeah.
Let me see, attaching my iris from a for a 5-year-old little boy named Jack. I was hoping that you could go over his pictures on YouTube. He has a history of severe behavior problems, hyperactivity, anxiety, depression, rage, and food sensitivities. His mom has been doing a wonderful job feeding him lots of raw foods for the past 4 months. What protocol would you recommend for him? I love it. Oh, thanks, man. Thanks, Tracy. Sweetheart, this is a little 5-year-old boy. Now, a 5-year-old boy, you can do lymphatic one liquid. You can do kidneys number one liquid. You can do endocrine glands liquid. And maybe want to do parasite M a little bit, clean out the fungus and stuff in them. But do lymphatic one liquid, kidney one liquid, endocrine gland liquid, and then go by weight on the bottle. I put weights on my bottles, so go by the weight there. Now, you see this young man's got a fairly large pupil. So we're seeing a lot of this now because the CNS, the central nervous system, seems to be more involved with these young folks. And we're bringing in souls to a very neurotoxic world. And this is the problem. I can say, Tracy, this the mother of this baby's got a real bad lymph system. This baby's got a real backed up lymph system. And part of the problem are these formulas. Now, she could have breastfed, but again, that depends upon her lymph system and her diet at the time of breastfeeding. At the same time, these formulas are just crap. We've got, and mine's coming, but this high-protein, high-fat formulas are just clogging babies like crazy. And this little young man has a very backed-up lymph system here. With that said, it'd be a little dark in the GI tract here and in the stomach area, very dark in this stomach area, and I don't like that. So you might even want to run a stomach and bowel number one on him and start cleaning up the gut here. Now, which eye am I looking at here? This is the right eye and this is the left eye, I take it. So this is the left eye. This is going to be around his heart area. That's all a heart weakness right there. So we've got a heart formula strengthening him up there a little bit. We're going to swing around here and big time kidney and adrenals. So you know, when it comes to neurotoxicity in today's world, just the vaccinations alone could have thrown this boy into hyperactivity. The fact that he has anxieties and all that, that's this right there. Real chronic adrenals there. Good. I mean, for a young man, this is not bad genes, though, but you're definitely going to work on the kidney and adrenals. That goes without saying. And then here's his groin over here, and this could be either his hip or his left testicle. A lot of lymph, see, but real strong. No real patterns around the body too much, but a lot of lymph area here. This is up in the forehead here. Now, parathyroid right there is parathyroid 930, parathyroid left eye. Now, that might account for a little bit of narrow prolapsing of the bowel here and depression. Right there, parathyroid, and all babies need to utilize calcium and parathyroid. Now, you got a lot of lymph in his throat. That parathyroid is surrounded in mucus. And we've got to detox this young man, and most people don't understand about that. Going to run higher temperatures. The boy's going to get a lot of mucus out, but he's 5 years old, state-owned. Now, that's not a good thing to hear, is it, that the state and the government owns your kids and make you feel too good. All right, here's the right eye here. So we're going to take a look here. Heavy lymph up again. Amazing you got these pictures. Here's the upper femur on the right side. Adrenals, the kidney doesn't look too bad here. This might be his little fella's prostate right there. Now, I'm back up here in the throat area, so this young man will have a sore throat for sure. This could be his thyroid area. And then you get up in his tonsils and his forehead up in here. Swinging around here, that's a little liver right there. Could give him a little anger, a detox. You could do just a few drops of the liver formula, too, on this young man. I'd have to map this out to tell. Let me see here, 3 o'clock. 10 o'clock, 7 o'clock. Well, that could be his liver and gallbladder right there. That would explain a lot about the accumulation of lymph and fat and stuff. So that could be liver, gallbladder. That would be more that could be the lower chest wall there. Could be his arm even. I'd have to map all that out. That's real close to the lower chest wall, upper chest wall there. But look at the lymph. Very dark in the gut. You want to clean this young man's bowels up, get him on a high fruit diet, and clean that lymph system up. And keep in mind, when you detox a five-year-old, higher fevers are in line. I would also use the brain and nerve formula number two, and you know, like six drops or something like that. With your other herbs, it's going to start strengthening his nervous system. I don't see the nerve rings, but I see the large pupil. Now, another thing you can do is time's rolling on here with this young man. You can use upper circulation to get up in there and start moving blood into brain tissue more aggressively, and at the same time, pick up brain and nerve. In other words, start strengthening the neurological system. And that'd be the central nervous system. You're going to swing around here, of course, pick up the adrenals, and that'll pick up the ANS, or the autonomic nervous system, sympathetic here, parasympathetic up here. Now here's one that someone likes a new video format.
Longer videos.
Yeah. When I close off of this, I'm gonna come around and start doing some videos on all your questions here. Can you separate these, or can we have another card where we can put this in?
Yeah.
Because I thought I would just take off and just start getting, trying to answer questions. I'm just trying to get caught up. These are brown eyes, no question. As a rule, this signifies cholesterol plaquing. That, when you start to see, and these are very difficult eyes to read like this. Brown eyes are difficult in the first place, and we have extra lights, and you can see there's even an extra light, I think, added into this picture. So very dark eyes. We can see here, but still, this looks like a shining cholesterol ring, which also gives you a poor circulation ring with it. With that said, hard to tell. There's so much light coming in here because the eyes are dark. It's hard to tell whether that you have a cataract in there or not. Pretty good genes here, I'll say that. There's a little bit of the adrenal. See how everybody looks different in the eye? That little one right there is the adrenal glands. Right there's the, is this a female or a male? The first attachment is male. The second photo is this is Desiree R. So this is a female. You can tell that up here in the eyelashes. Okay, she's had one miscarriage, trouble conceiving, frequent urination. Started about 10 years ago. Pain, dull ache, swelling on my left lower side of my abdomen at times. Not sure if it's pain in my ovary or your colon. Okay, so this is your left eye. Let's look. In the colon, you have right down in the bottom of your descending bowel, which is down the left breast straight down, you've got several places, mid-descending, on down around the sigmoid flexor, and then along the sigmoid, you've got a lot of pain. This is where your pain can come from, is all these dark areas here in the sigmoid bowel. That's about located in the left ovarian area, and that's you got to work on your GI tract. Now, stomach and bowel number, your GI broom, lymphatic one capsules, start cleaning up your bowels, because there's a couple places here that if you're feeling pain in there, that's not good. That's a warning. Definitely clean this up so you don't have to have that cut out. Here's the pituitary weakness. And I want to look at the right eye and see if I see that there. Because if you're having miscarriages and you're having problem conceiving, you can go to the ovaries or you can go to the pituitary. I would do the female reproductive formula. That'll reach up and grab this pituitary. Right there is your pituitary weakness. Or get you a glandular, or use the endocrine gland formula. The adrenals go without saying. Here's a kidney, not too bad. We start getting into the vaginal wall here. I would douche with the Heal-All tea for a couple of weeks. Got a little uterine and vaginal wall weakness here. Then we pick up the bladder and lower back. And you're showing a little bladder, lower back, mid-back here, as much as I can see here. Hard to say up here in the throat area here. But you got pretty good genes, that's for sure. But obviously your lymph system isn't doing it like you would like to have. Because, now this is a little brighter, but look at the size of her pupil here. Now it could be that it's not big there, and it's big here. Now this is the right eye, and it could be bigger on the right side, or it could just be all this light. But all this light pouring in should constrict the pupil, not expand it. So this is a dilated pupil, could be some central nervous system, but this is a good gene person, but a lot of nerve rings here, and a lot more nerve rings in the right eye than the left eye, and this breeds nothing but weakness in the neurological system. This is I think a cholesterol ring or malabsorption ring, definitely cholesterol, you see it right there. And cholesterol, remember, is what? The body's main antacid. Now, you got good genes, minor kidney adrenals. You've got a good body here to take to Wellville. That's all I can tell you. Move your lymph system, get your kidneys and adrenals, work on them. Strengthen up your nervous system with brain and nerve. Clean up the bowels. And you'll have a good way to go, Desiree. Use the female reproductive formula, honey, or get into the pituitary. She calls this a lazy eye. That's the nervous system. You can use upper circ and brain and nerve to get in this brain of yours and fix it up. But you've got, it has to be lymphatically suppressing, because I don't see any major patterns to show us weaknesses. Or I'm just not, this eye is just not good enough, but I think it is. I think you got really good genes, same thing on the other. You got really good genes, you're just not moving lymph on at your level, and you're getting that cholesterol ring. Of course, here's the adrenals, and work on your pituitary or female reproductive area. This is from Germany. Let me see. Eye pictures are too dark. Did not. Yeah, these are pretty dark, my friend. Is this you, Miko? Miko? This is Denicia. So I don't know. We don't have any eyes for her.
Yeah, I didn't print those.
Too dark, Denicia. Yeah. Too dark eyes, sweetheart. Try to lighten them up. Too. These are too dark, too. No offense. You just, when you have this dark eyes, you got to get a couple of light sources in there for me. Yeah. M-A-I-K-O. Look at how dark, sweetheart. I mean, it's really dark, honey. I can't see anything in there. I mean, we can try to get a light and see, but let me step in front just 2 seconds. There we go. Sorry about that. Nope. I could see a little bit. It wouldn't be worth me saying something that might not be appropriate there. So if you, I'm not going to read too many more eyes on this, because this would be, I could just never keep up with you guys. You guys are too good. Now, I have to apologize here, because this is like a bunch of pages. And it's just really hard for me to read a bunch of pages here. This is Rinustak, male, 54 years old, and I am from the Netherlands. This guy has been listening to our videos. Thank you, my friend, so much. Welcome to the group. The weak veins in the legs that my doctor said they were incurable and cutting them out would be only remedy. Varicose veins, remember parathyroid weakness, very important here. I had swollen ankles during the day. Now, what would cause swollen ankles? Kidney weakness. So here's your kidney weakness. You know you have acidosis, and your body's taking your calcium out, so there's a parathyroid weakness. Work on your parathyroid weakness for your veins and your legs. Swollen ankles, there's your kidneys going right there. Pains in the lower back, that's going back to your kidneys. A tumor in my right knee pit. The tumor started to come out with a lot of pus after eating mostly grapes for weeks. Look at that guy, he's kicking butt. Now I am still detoxifying. Well, here's your kidney, my friend. It's why you have the tumor in the back of the leg. Kidneys, kidneys, kidneys. That means your adrenals are there too. The veins, parathyroid. The tinnitus symptoms in my head, pressure. He grew up on a dairy farm. As I push higher to go fruit and green juices, I feel better and more improvement. Keep going. And I am convinced that, yes. My friend W.I.M.'s wife, Rhea, is showing the first symptoms of Parkinson's disease, and I have been encouraging Wim and Rhea to go raw as much as possible. Yeah, I would do it yesterday instead of tomorrow. I told them about your YouTube channel, but their English is not good. Well, I proposed them to send you pictures to read his eyes. Okay. My friend, I'm not going to keep going on here just because of all this. I'm just you could give me a lot of cases. Here's a little kid, 4 years old, pneumonia, and from which she even went into a coma. Holy crap. Move this kid's lymph system, get her adrenals up and her lymphatics up. Here's age 11. She fell off her bike and she had 3 holes in her head, broke her left wrist, and suffered from concussion. Well, you know what? You're just getting everybody healthy, because even from trauma, if you don't move limp, those weaknesses will hang around for a lifetime. Here's another one, age 28, suffered from nerve compression in her shoulders, both sides of her body. Her hands were thick and painful, and she had a bump in her neck, which she still has now, and which is painful. That's a major lymphatic problem. This is all. Remember, she feels thick. Her hands feel thick. She's bloated. She's highly acidic. And again, 28, big-time kidney and adrenals. The tumor in the neck just shows that. Move those lymphs, guys. Age 30, flying rheumatism, and she was given 30 injections for that. Look at that crap. Again, going back to acidosis again. Age 37, pulmonary embolism, thrombosis. Again, move those lymphs, get on the blood formula, clean the blood up, clean the liver, clean the spleen, move the lymph, get the bowels cleaned up. All those things are essential when you start getting into these type of cases. Here's age 66. Parkinson's. I mean, this is cinnamon. Here's the cinnamon I talk about. This is very addicting. This is worse than cocaine. And so you really want to get in the upper circ, brain and nerve, move lymph, brain lesions, get those brain lesions out of there. Very easy. You see the chiropractor's wife on there, which had, 4 or 5 brain lesions. She doesn't have them anymore. Rhea consulted a naturopath, and he prescribed herbs, basal lymph. Well, he didn't prescribe near enough. You really want to get way on down the line for Rhea. Rhea, honey, you got to get your butt moving and get out of this. Okay? I'm not going to go over it anymore, but let's go over the eyes here. These are R-I-N-U-S eyes. Now, this is his right eye. Now, he was born on a dairy farm. I was born, we had farms. And thank God at the time they weren't dairy. Gee, many Christmas. My sister had a dairy farm, lasted about 6 months, and down they went. Now, there's one thing you can... What do we all see at looking at this guy's eyes? What do we see? Do we see the connection to Mr. Dairy Farm? Well, remember... Dairy Farmer. See all that thick lymph? See all that thick lymph? Man, you got good genes, but you got a heck of a lymph system here. Now look at your bowel. There's that rope around the collaret, known as the GI tract. There's that collaret, so you're malabsorbed. And there's that little brown ring around the pupil, malabsorbed. Got a little stomach weakness going on there. See that darkness in the stomach area? I don't like that. You either got a drug or you burnt your stomach. Clean that stomach up. Use GI broom, stomach and bowel. There's all kinds of herbs, marshmallows, slippery elms. Of course, they're always in the GI tract formulas and stuff, obviously. This is your kidney on the right. Let me see, what do we got, a right eye? There's your kidney, my friend. Now, that's a weak kidney and a weak adrenal gland. You got to get a hold of that one. Here's your leg, your right leg, and a big time in the knee area. And then your groin here. This is groin moving right into your right hip and then into your testicle. All those are your weaknesses right in that whole area right there. And then we move into your right arm, which is weak. And then we move into your chest. Thick lymph, thick lymph, thick lymph, thick lymph here, guy. Get that moving. This is pituitary. And to see how that's moving up, we call that radii solaris. Radius solaris. And that goes right up. Not very deep yet, but it can. Pituitary. Looks pretty good, man. You look pretty good. Here's upper neck here. A lot of congestion in the throat. Minor thyroid here. But and a little lower back tied into your kidney, but big time kidney, legs, groin, got to move lymph, because it'll chew up your legs and knees and hips and everything else, and you're starting to see that happening in your family. Tidbit of skin ring here. Now, colors are off in this picture, I'm sure. It doesn't fit with the skin tone or anything else, so it's hard to tell. Obviously a blue eye. This is the left eye. And again, this is... R-E-N-U-S. Left kidney. Big time genetics there, right even up to the stomach. Again, more stomach weaknesses. A lot of stomach going on here. Got to clean that stomach up. Look at that prolapse. See how that bowel, if it went around, it'd be way up here. But it's dropped like a flat top. That's prolapsing. It means that transverse colon's prolapsed. Well, it's a natural event of years of proteins and, shall I say, animal eating, genetics and things like that. Sucking the calcium out. They asked me about protein. One of the biggest things protein does is suck the calcium out of the human body. Remember, man cannot use protein. He needs amino acids, but not protein. Now, here's a knee here, left side. Here's a groin and hip left side. Here's also a little left testicle. And as we swing around, we're heading toward the spleen. I'd clean my spleen up. Now, this is a swelling in the left chest wall. If it was a woman, that could be the beginning of a tumor. See how that little white dot? See when we talked about the dots? See that thickness in that? That's right in the left breast, chest area. Little bronchi, little congestion in the lower lobe here. This is heading up toward the shoulder, the ear, now getting up into the neck and the cerebellum and up into the brain area. Someday get up with upper circuit, brain and nerve, of course, but really focus on your lymph system. Get your skin, get your colon, get your stomach cleaned up. Get those fruits in those stomach and always work on your kidneys. You'd think there'd be a little bit of parathyroid. You can barely see it, but a little bit of parathyroid there, because I'm looking at legs and stuff going, So I'm looking a little parathyroid there. There you go. Thank you, my friend. I hope that was helpful to you. Now, this is Carla. Now, these are brown eyes. At least they look brown. But look when I show up the left eye. A little light in there, a little blue along here. But I think these are brown eyes. But notice the shades of brown. You have a lighter brown, darker brown, still darker brown, still darker brown. These are all different levels of chronic or of lymph stagnation. In a brown eye, brown doesn't mean necessarily chronic, but the darker brown stages, you could definitely dub them as chronic. Now this is up in the forehead area. Now this is the left eye, this is the back of the head area. Little pituitary going on right there as well. You need to get up in your brain and clean the sinuses, the lymphatics. Get up with upper circuit brain and nerve someday and fix these deep areas, because these can be future brain lesions. Again, you're getting moving up into the cerebellum where you could have equilibrium or dizzy. Notice how small your pupil is. A lot of stress in there. Or acidosis. A left side, this is left kidney, left groin. A left kidney, that's either rectal or vaginal wall. My guess is that's rectal wall right there at the rectum. And then we have the vaginal area. So a douching would be good for you. By cleaning up the bowel area, it should clean up this rectal area. You can do real low implants of Heal-All T. We're getting up into the back here now. We're getting into the upper lumbar area, up here in the throat a little bit. All these darker areas need to be cleaned up. And of course, there's a skin issue going on. And this might be the beginnings of cholesterol. See how that little haze look at the top here? But you're very acidic. These are very acid eyes. Yeah, here you got another. Here's your right eye. And see that little cholesterol? They call this arcus senilis, or they did way back. That never leads to anything good, dear ones. Clean all that. This is your back of your neck here. This is the right eye, of course. Look at that kidney, real dark in that area. Again, there's a groin kidney. Here's the back, takes up from the kidney here. This is the lower back, real dark here. So there's no question she's having or he's having lower back. Then here's upper neck. Here's throat. Tonsil, that dark patch. Gallbladder, liver. We really get into your gallbladder and liver and clean it up, although we're close to the arm right here. But good genes, very good genes, skin here. You know, these are not that, but get very good genes. Just get your lymph moving real dark in the bowel area. So just clean up your bowels and your lymphatic system. This is a good eye, even though it looks, You don't have any major lacunas. So I like that. First off, I love what you're doing. Thank you, dear Carla. I am addicted to the videos. Well, thank you, dear one. I get yourself well. That's the intention of these videos, is so you all have your remedies. Very important. We love you all. She's Carla Redman. Phone number, I go back. She goes by Carla Jean 68 on YouTube. I am going to be taking a month off. Good. I have an appointment next September. Holy crap. I will see you soon. Good, dear. Thank you, Carla. Thank you, sweetheart. I hope that helps you, dear. I might have to come in on the weekend and do the questions and answers. I mean, because I'm just not. It's a lot of time going over things, and so you just necessarily have it. Well, these are tight. These are good. I like them that way. And this is another very detailed writing here, so I apologize, but if it's too detailed, there's two people here. Here's Zoe. So let's do this one. Let's see who Zoe is here. Zoe's Eyes, 37-year-old. I have been working diligently on my health since last July. Good, 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 good. First, when I decided I could no longer take the acid reflux pills my doctor was prescribing me, I was in so much pain I could no longer sleep or eat. I felt like I was dying a very slow and very painful death. Man was raised no sugar, no dairy, which is excellent. At age 16, I got my period. This is a female. I got her period at age 16. That's a little late. So that would suggest pituitary. So let's look here. Right eye. What do we got right there? We got pituitary. What we have is blue eyes that look green and orange. So what's all this orange in the bowel area? Yeah, sulfur. Now look at how dark. And it could just be the coloration of the picture, so forgive me. But for these pictures, the stomach looks like you have some genetics there in the stomach and a little weak here in the stomach area. With that said, you have the colorant of malabsorption. See this? Thick lymph here. But it's the sulfur that's holding everybody in on you. All this thick stuff here, this yellowish is your lymph, making your eye look green. And with the orange and yellow, you know, you blue, you get your greens. Now, this is, let me see here. This is the appendix. Not real happy if you still have that baby. It doesn't look like you still have it. If you do, you want to clean your bowels up. You want to do it anyway because you see you're prolapsed here. You got a fair amount of weaknesses around the gut area. No question about that. So we have a little bit of hip going on up in there. That would push this little dark area to be the pancreas, and then that darker area could be your gallbladder. So real careful, here's your liver. So you want to clean your liver and gallbladder up. And when I say clean up, use fruits, berries, and melons, and herbs. Yeah, that'll just cut through the chase right there. I got a little knee going on here, and I swing around, and here's your kidney. Got some weaknesses in that right kidney, and then there's your adrenals, pretty chronic. When we get to your back, we've got lower back and mid-back. See that big lacuna? That's mid-back. And you got something dark going on there. Could just be a genetic spot, or you got some deterioration in the upper lumbar, lower T-spine. You know, your back could be stronger. And then we get into the throat area, and you got a swelling in the throat right there. Here's your thyroid, parathyroid area. This even could be the parathyroid pushed up here even. That's why you have to be careful when you analyze eyes. And that's why it's important to correlate their symptoms with your eyes. This is back in the cerebellum. Back in the right ear cerebellum is giving you equilibrium dizzy. This is in the forehead. Here's bronchial trunks. Here's lungs. I would use a lung twos down the road because you really need to clean and strengthen your lungs. That's a weakness there in the mid-lobe of the right lung and the lower lobe and the bronchial trunks that feed them. Wow, listen to that rain. Holy moly. And you want to clean all this up, sweetheart. Get in your lymph system, clean your bowels up, get absorption going on, get your kidneys filtering, get your adrenals up, pituitary up, because you didn't start mincing till 16. That's way too late, and that shows pituitary. Looking at Zoe's left eye, we see pretty much more of the same. The fact that these fibers aren't straight, of course, does suggest parathyroid weakness and the weakening of connective tissue. Now, what do we have right here at 9:30, left eye? Look how big it is. Thyroid, parathyroid. big time parathyroid. Her fibers would be straighter had she had better calcium utilization in her life. Even her structure of her bowel would be better. But you really have to work on your GI tract, Zoe. You just got a lot of weaknesses through here, a lot of sulfur in here. You got to clean all that out, use the broom and stuff. Here's a knee, here's an adrenal kidney better on this side. We get into the rectal and the female areas. Definitely do some douching yourself. Then we pick up a little bit of bladder and lower back. Look at that. And a little bit of mid back. Over here we have some bronchial trunks, not bad. A little congestion in the lung here though on the left side. Now that's lower lobe. I'd work on my lungs right off. I don't like that. See that dark spot with a lot of lymph around it? I don't like that. So clean that out, clean your lungs out, get your lymph moving. This is down near the left ovary too. But good strong genes basically. You know, when you look at everybody else, good strong genes, got to work on your gut here, get that lymph cleaned up. I use brain and nerve sometime, get up there and try to get these spots out of the head area. Now we have eyes of someone else here. This is like a 5-page letter, so you have to forgive me because I just don't have the time to pour over all these things. This is Rodney. Now, Rodney is 47 years old, where Zoe was 37. So Rodney's 47. I'm sorry, Chris, I'm doing this for you. Get you all messed up there. He's about 20 to 25 pounds overweight, had kidney stones at age 44. So what do we know about Rodney? Kidneys, right? Smoked since he was 17 years old, quit early December, did a 7-day pure fruit juice fast, that's pretty good, in March, after he quit the patch and stopped eating wheat with me last October, he lost 20 pounds in 2 weeks, look at that, the no wheat diet, absolutely, good job. So sperm's up, he is bald, all right, so here's the problem, here's a 47-year-old male that's bald. He is bald and has very oily facial skin, but very dry skin over the rest of the body. So what's going on? We ain't moving lymph, are we? Matter of fact, what takes off hair? Acids. Think chemo. Acids. And that's what system deals with acids? The lymphatic system, of course. He has a huge amount of mucus in his system. No kidding. Huge amount of mucus in his system. He has erection problems, no sex drive. Okay, that's, again, he has a big stomach and gains all his weight there. He had post-traumatic stress syndrome for many years. Where was he? Explosive ordnance disposal. Oh, that's a good job. Holy crap. His diet used to be the Atkins diet. Oh, Rodney. You about killed yourself there. I currently have him on, what the heck is that? Never heard of that. Anyway, thanks Zoe. Let's go over Rodney's eyes here. Again, see all the heavy orange in the eye? That's sulfur. See all the yellow? That's subacute. First stage is acute, which turns the eye white, subacute yellow, chronic brown, and black degenerative. So you see all this orange? There is some malabsorption, very thick around the wall. It's lodged in your bowel wall. It's even in your stomach, creates an acid reflux and irritation to the stomach. You have some stomach weaknesses. This is your right eye, so we're up in the forehead here. Right here is the tonsils. And right in that little bitty flat football of a pattern is your parathyroid gland. Work on that parathyroid gland. You guys are learning a lot more about the parathyroid than most physicians even think about. Again, here is a swelling in your thyroid. You might have a little polyp, but that's a lymph swelling in the thyroid area. And then bad tonsil, not happy. Clean it up, get it healthy if it's still in there. If not, that's what it looked like. Throat area here, could have a little sore throat, don't freak out, upper neck here. Looks not so bad in the back, a little bit not so bad, minor, fix all this stuff up, kidney not too bad, clean that up, fix that up, here's your leg, your right leg, so you got a weakness in that whole right leg and a little bit in the groin here. Pick up the hip here, and this is all in the right hip. So you can fill that, and then we're going to probably pick up some gallbladder here, clean up your liver, gallbladder, little weakness in your right testicle there. So you want to, I would make sure my PSAs were in good shape, and then you could take male reproductive. The male reproductive formula will bring your sperm up, give you better erections, things like this, but you don't want to have high PSAs. You don't want to have inflammation or acidosis, because that's hot. Acids are heat producing, and when you add hot on top of hot, that's what oncology does, and they're insane. So you never put hot on top of hot. You don't try to neutralize an acid condition with more acids. You just create a bigger problem. And that's what allopathies, they don't get it. You don't do that. Maybe a little bit of skin could be stronger for sure. Pituitary, clean up those sinuses. But this is a good eye. Just that your sulfur's really locking you in there, irritating the gut wall for sure, and that's all acid reflux. But what happens is that this sulfur stays in there for a lifetime. He probably got this when he was a kid. Look how it's spread out toward the lymph nodes. He probably got this when he was a young man. That started malabsorption. It started a low-grade acid reflux. And then, of course, as it started suppressed lymphatics, it created a greater interstitial lymphatic constipation, giving him more of an acid burn. This isn't a hydrochloric acid burn. This is a sulfur/cellular waste acid burn, worst kind of acid burn. Nothing you can take to remedy it. And more you take add acids, the more you can dig yourself a pretty big hole. Right side, same thing. Strong. Pretty strong. Look at all these fibers. Nice and strong. But you got the sulfur around the collaret there. And then here's your kidney on the side. This is actually your left leg. So you got a weakness in the left leg. Here's your kidney here. So it's pretty dark there. Adrenals. Hard to see your adrenals. They're drowned in mucus. Get that out of there before you start popping cysts or tumors on the adrenals. Shifting more here. There's the male reproductive area. Heavy lymphatic stagnation in the male, so you better, I'd have a blood work, check my PSAs before I started jumping on hot male reproductive formulas. You can play with that thing later, get it healthy, so when you play with it, it'll give you some years of fun, or whatever. You've got to take care of this problem first. Don't go putting yourself on hot herbs. You can give yourself prostate cancer if you're not careful. Now we pick into the bladder here. There's a little bladder weakness, and then we slip into the lower back area, a little spot in the mid-back, and then we get up into the neck and throat again. But not bad. A lot of congestion in the sinus and head. Little spot in the head. See that little black spot up in the head area? Get that out of there. That's right at the pituitary area, hypothalamus area. Get that out of there. That means upper circ, brain and nerve. Clean your sinuses lymphatically and clean your body up. Got a good body, though. So you guys have fun. You got good bodies, blocked up lymph systems, of course, like the rest, and take off and have some fun with that. And thanks so much, Zoe and Rod. Thanks for your pictures. And take off. Enjoy your ride. This is a good ride. Have fun with it. We're coming down here. I apologize. I want to show you this one. All you on Facebook already got to see this lovely soul. I love this lady to death. She's such a sweet, sweet lady. Look at there. Everybody laughed at me on the hair thing. And look at her hair. I've known her for a while. See that hair? And see that? See that? Now, what happened here? This is July 2012. Hair in 7 months. Upper circ and brain and nerve. What did I tell you guys? And I've been telling you. Look at her beautiful head of hair. Keep working. Remember, this is an effect of something much more serious. And balding, it's like this young man, 47, he's balding. No, that's the lymph system. And again, nothing ever good comes of balding. That's your Alzheimer's, your Alzheimer's, your dementia, your, you know, all of those. So move those acids out, and she's doing a great job on that. Moving the lymph, got beautiful head of hair, and that's what it is. You can put hair on anything. But always ask why. Why did you lose your hair? Oh, it's just natural. My parents did. It's genetics. Oh, is it? So that beautiful work on yourself there, honey. Beautiful work, Wendy. Wendy smiling. Just kick butt. Love it. Love it, love it, love it, dear. Proof's in the pudding. Now, this is from Bob. Hey, Bob. My grandfather was Bob. I got Robert. And my son got Rob. Don't ask. I was wondering if you could read my eyes real quick. I will. Absolutely. Supposed to be brown or blue. What do you think? What do you think, Bob? Here's brown. So I don't think brown's going to be the way we're going to go. I think you're right. I think you're totally blue, my friend. The Radius Solaris are pretty obvious. Yeah, I know. Well, I love you guys. You see, these guys are getting really good and educated. You guys are definitely the healers of the now and of the future. Yep. Yep. Well, you first have to cut off their feet. To cut off their feet is to clean up your GI tract. Notice they start their origin genetically in the embryonic trunk, which is the stomach and bowels. And there you go. So you got to cut off that first. You got to clean up the bowel area. And then you get upper circ, or you can even do it during this, get upper circ and brain and nerve, because that's what we're after. It might have a little hint of poor circulation there. That's a violet ring up there. I don't like that. That might be a hint of some poor circulation. You're going to want to do circulation, but keep in mind, the blood is totally effectual by the lymph. So circulation, most of poor circulation is a lymphatic problem, like a lot of leukemias, which are blood cancers, are lymphatics. Very dark around the bowels. This is a yellowish. So we're in a subacute stage here, heading towards chronics. There could be some more brown around there that this picture's not showing up. Now this is the right eye. This looks more like your leg, not your kidney. Your right leg, 6 o'clock, straight down, and that's 6 o'clock, straight down. So this is the right leg. Here's your kidney in there. Not too bad. A little weak. There's your adrenals up there. But this is your right leg. Man, you got weaknesses from the knee down. The ankle, holy crap. Here's your appendix up here, which is not real happy. See that black little slice? There's your right testicle. And then this, all this thick is just lymph, 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 lymph. And you got a little liver. Clean up the liver, gallbladder, a little arm weakness. Here's your chest wall. But, you know, you clean lymph, you're going to be in good shape. Now, this is your cerebellum in your right ear, mastoid ear area. So if you have any dizziness or equilibrium, there's why. Here's your throat over here, a little weakness in the throat. Parathyroid stuck right in there. And then you got your upper T spine probably. I don't think that it could be in the lower C's. Then you've got starting toward your mid back and heading toward your lower back there. But really got pretty good genes here, dear my friend, Bob. And this is skin ring. Sorry, Chris. Now, this is the left side of Bob. Now, that's pretty gnarly, ain't it? I'm going to have to say, Bob, I'm going to pick on you. This is your left kidney, and nobody's going to like that view. Woohoo! Man, that's a pretty weak left kidney. Holy crap. So you want to get in there. I'd even use a glandular, Bob. I would use we have the raw ones from New Zealand, and I would use that. That's pretty weak. The heavy congestion in your upper femur down to your knee there. So if you're not careful, you're going to feel your knee here. Here's your groin. And then you're going to move into the hip here and then into the left testicle. Swinging around here, here's your, let me see here. Yeah, I'm going to say this is probably your prostate and your male here. And then this is going to be your bladder and your lower back. You're always going to see a lower back to some extent with kidneys. They go together. A lot of times you're going to pick up your bladder with your kidneys and then prostate. And there's your prostate. So you want to, you know, get kidney repaired, get this cleaned up here, maybe even repair the prostate here, lower back here. And here's your radius solaris up here, like you said. Here's your cerebellum here. This, I don't like this dark one either. Clean up this bowel. Get this transverse colon cleaned up. And then get up in the upper circ, brain, and nerve. Got some nerve rings here anyway, but you want to get up in that brain area, Bob. Cut that off. Clean up the gut. Get the kidneys back online. See how all that's connected and how we found all this? And look at all that heavy lymph in there. Thick, thick, thick lymph, Bob. So get yourself focused. Get on those kidneys. Rebuild that kidney there. Get that lymph cleaned out. Get in the upper circ, brain, and nerve. Start healing up some of these spots here. But clean up this. Spend some time on your GI tract. All right. Now, this is Chris. The reason these are in a chart is Chris is one of our clients. He's also a practitioner. So let's look at his right eye first. Now you notice, here's that bowel wall. Notice some are real thin, close into the pupil, and others are expanded out. There's different thoughts on the subject. Some think that actually represents the actual size, that some bowels are bigger in diameter than others. I can't say there, because I just haven't spent the time to research that, and I don't know how you would, except doing crazy barium enemas and, doing a scan, taking a look at bowel shapes and sizes. Jensen did a lot of that in terms of looking at prolapsus and things like that. In his books, he shows a lot of x-rays related to a lot of areas. The work's already been done there. Obviously, around the collarette here, you've got that interstitial lymphatic constipation going on there. And it's giving you that little malabsorption ring. This could be a little cataract coming. Heavy thunder. See how these eyes are, it could just be the camera, but these eyes are blue eyes. They look a little green, but they are blue. You see the stomach ring around there, so very acidic. Now, when you start to see this stomach ring looking darker, that means that the weaknesses are starting to set in. Low hydrochloric acid. You don't want to give hydrochloric acid with low hydrochloric acid. Stop eating meat and all nuts and beans and let the body heal a little bit. Now, this is the right eye. There's a little bit of kidney going on here and adrenals. Not bad, though. And it's a little open here in terms of this lesion or this lacuna. There's open and closed lacunas. See how this is open? And see how this is closed? Now, see this closed one, how there's thick around it? That's what Jensen was talking about. The lymph system in these weaker areas are even worse than they are in the stronger areas. And this is a stronger area and it's open, but around this area is the lymph system. And this area encompasses the arm and the lower ribs of the right side. Again, we're going right in here. We're moving into the gallbladder liver area. Swinging around to the pancreatic and ovary. Swinging around to the hip, the groin, and then back to the leg and kidney. A lot of lymph in the groin area here. But not bad. This is bronchial trunk here. Little weakness in the midlobe of the right lung. There is a midlobe in the right lung. Keep in mind, three lobes on the right side, two in the left. German iridology showed three lobes on the left side for years. Hopefully somebody tuned them up. Got some kind of brown stuff up in the brain here, some type of chemical, and I don't know what it is, but you see that little light brown stuff here? Some type of chemical. You have feints of it around. This is a couple of lacunas up in the head area, and this is in your cerebellum here. So that's an equilibrium dizzy center, of course. Upper circuit brain and nerve here. Sinuses up in here when you see that lymph up in here. But pretty good eye, pretty strong. These aren't deep areas of weakness. Notice the, of course, it could be the way she took her eyes, but these are deeper. And then I wanted to show you. Yeah, you can see the depth difference. The depth difference of that. Here's a good picture. This turned out really beautiful. Showing you the depth differences. When you have a good picture, here's what it looks like. The clarity of this brown picture we did is I don't know. Kathy was helping me at the time, and she, after 15 years, finally got the art of using a second light. Here's my main camera light, and here's my second light. You see how beautiful we got this brown eye? And I mean, the depth of these are just beautiful to show you that there is this depth. Now, if I turned your eyes sideways, the acute stages starts to lift all these fibers up off the eye. It starts to lift these fibers up off the eye. The subacute lifts them further. The brown lifts them further. We showed you that in our class this year, showing how the fibers actually are pulled up off the eye. And that's where you get that 3D look. And then when you have degeneration, black, you see it looks like a hole. So it's almost like if a cells die in your liver, they die in the brain where the liver is controlled. I mean, because it's that's that symbiotic neurological relationship. It's the nervous system that makes this science work. And the nervous system transmutes frequencies of electromagnetic energy, which is color, chemistry, everything's involved in those frequencies. But as we can tell here, yours are not real deep, which makes this so much easier to deal with. These are weaknesses, strong constitution, but these weaknesses are still weaknesses, but you can get them better. And I'll just say, honk on your lymph. You're already on our programs. You know, we're already working with you, but I just would show you this. This is the left eye, so over here, you know, we got these are scatterings. This is in the left ear. This is in the shoulder. This is in the lungs or the bronchi. But they're not very deep here. This is the left breast. So there is a weakness there. And there's that lymph stagnation in that left breast still. So you got to be careful there. There's the spleen. We come around to a knee. A little bit of kidney. Not bad. Not bad. Little female maybe there. Little bladder maybe there. But here's the lower back. A lot of inflammation there. But not bad. I mean, not really bad. Here's some upstairs here, and you see how it indented the bowel wall. Total genetics. See how it influenced the bowel wall like that? Went right into that bowel wall. Means that weakness came out of this gut tissue, and that's in the brain. And still affected the trunk. Something up there in the brain here on your right side, dear, to just clean all that out. But good eyes. Good strong constitution. Well, I think that just about concludes our iris show today. But I want you to use this as a tool to learn, not just for yourselves, but for others. And for those of you that are learning iridology, just a great science. Don't make more out of it than it is. Keep it simple. Stay balanced. You got some iridologists out there claiming they can see cancer in the eye. Oh, there's no physician that can do that except a pathologist. So, you know, even medical doctors tend to state things that are not always, you know, the case. Oh, that's cancer. No, they should say, it looks like cancer. I need to take a cell to a pathologist. Irregardless, what's causing the damage to the cell? Acids. And what system deals with acids? The great lymphatic system. So it was a real pleasure. You know, our time is very short here. So we're going to cut off on this video. I will set up this weekend. I will bring this physical body in here, set it down here, tie it to the chair, and talk to you about your questions and stuff that you're asking, because I really appreciate you asking. It tells me you're concerned about your health, you're going after your health issues, and you got me on your side 100% when you do that, okay? So I love you all very much, and thank you so much for taking time. What was it? Babe, 335 days on a juice fast. 336 days today, probably, or seven on a juice fast. Babe, you're going into the Guinness Book of World Records. Good work. She's not dead yet, is she? Feeling better and better. I admire every one of you guys. You give me a lot of energy to hear. You're helping me after all these years. I feel like I got a good team working with me now. And even though I don't get a chance to hug you all, here's a big hug. And let's hug the world today. Have fun this weekend. I'll be talking to you Monday. Thank you. Bye-bye. Namaste.